Do you react quickly and flip out on your boyfriend? Well, all you have to do is follow these 5 tips to help you with how to control your emotions when he is teasing you, trying to cause arguments, or playing games with you. Hello, my name is Greta Berishita. I'm dating and relationship coach for women. For the awesome high-value woman secrets, subscribe to my channel and hit the bell to be notified when I upload new videos every Wednesday and Sunday. And just before I share with you the 5 tips, don't forget to take my free self-awareness test to find out are you a woman of low value or high value, which I will drop down in the video description box below. And if you like any of my hoodies, you can get them in my YouTube store. Now, before I go over my 5 tips, ladies, please remember, the world is not heaven, and people like to use others for their own advantage. And when you share your secrets, vulnerabilities, or insecurities, you are literally providing manipulator the tools how to play you. Now, without further ado, the tip number 1. Do not take it personally. When water is shaken, it does not erupt. Water is calm, and this is exactly how you need to be. If someone is deliberately offensive towards you in the hope of making you either insecure or reactive, you must simply be aware of your own actions. For example, do not react because the person is aware of their unkind behavior and you have control of your response. So in this case, you do not take it personally and you respond in a calm manner rather than erupting like a shaken can of Coke, which explodes everywhere. And this is when he gets a chance to call you what? Crazy. Whereas if you respond calmly, you show the other person that you are disciplined and mature and that you do not perform in circus. Therefore, instead of labeling you crazy, he starts to respect you more. Remember the saying, sticks and stones? You are controlled and wise one, whereas they are presented as foolish. Number 2, leave the room. If you are early in your transition to controlling your emotions, you may feel the urge to clap back. So in this instance, you simply leave the room. Why? Because this will prevent you from saying anything that you should not have. Do not worry if the other person thinks we have won because we have caused you to leave. The fact that you have not reacted emotionally is good. People who tend to poke others with sticks are the ones who enjoy drama and try to pull you down to their level. Do not allow yourself to do this. And leaving the room will be another way to show that you do not perform in circus. Number 3, poker face. If you are in a situation where you cannot leave a room as you both are in a cabin, airplane, or car, then I strongly suggest you present a poker face. What does this mean? You behave normal, or you look out the window, or you go on your phone. Ladies, note this. When you show that you are upset with the manipulator, it gives him satisfaction because it shows that you care. So you keep rewarding this petty, insecure man with your attention and make him feel good. Therefore, he does it more. Whereas instead, if he pushes you further, talk in a calm manner and respond to his comments. So you're essentially playing along to his silly game without giving him a reaction. For example, if he says, "Let me drop you home," after 20 minutes in a date, you say, "Okay," and you let him drop you home. If on the way he calls his friends saying that he will be at their place soon, you remain quiet and let him take you home. Do not react. And if there are any shops on the way home, even better, you can ask him to drop you off there so you can make the most of your day, meet other people and go shopping. This way you are showing that his manipulations are not affecting your day. The result usually is that the manipulator gets upset himself as his game didn't work and shows his cards in the open by asking you why you are not upset. Do you have any feelings for him or why you don't care? This is when you get your confirmation that all this behavior was a plan to provoke you. Ladies, if you want to know the manipulative games men play on women, check out my video right here. And I also have a more detailed video on sale for this on my website, gretaberishita.com. Number 4, knowledge is power. Controlling your emotions is easy when you know the person's game book. The majority of men have a set of games which he use over and over again because we worked in the past. Once you see the game, you won't feel the need to react, as you know it's all a game to get your attention and reaction. For example, one of my clients' boyfriend, well, now an ex, tried to bait her into chasing him. So he started posting happy images with other girls on a yacht on his WhatsApp status in the hope of her reacting and messaging him. Did she? Of course she did not, because she knew it was a game. After this, he removed his WhatsApp picture to give her the impression that he has blocked her. Did she message him? No, because she clearly knew that he wanted her to react and panic. And of course, emotions of anger were there for this client, but she kept it together to ensure that she did not fall into his obvious trap. The result was he put the picture back on a day later, called her and shared a story of how he was a model in the music video which explained the yacht and the pics with other girls. Now, if she would have reacted to this, she would have looked like a fool, as she would have shown him that she doesn't trust him and he would have labeled her as crazy, even though he was the one that was trying to provoke her. By having knowledge of men's games, she was able to keep her emotions in check. Along with the support of my VIP group, which again, you can find the details of that in my video description box below. Number 5, just laugh. Laughter is the best medicine for this, and let me explain why. Whatever scenario you face, just laugh it off because you immediately disable the offender. It shows that you do not take their insults personally or seriously and that we are in fact the clown in the situation. You can ignore them as you're not focused on what we are saying, meaning we have no purpose and will eventually learn we cannot behave this way with you. You do not need to verbally respond. Simply smile and give thumbs up or carry on with your day, as there is no need to waste time on drama like the offender wants you to. Ladies, you do not engage in a verbal mess. You simply leave it alone as you have better things to do with your time. Remember, high value women do not perform in circus. If you would like to know how to control your emotions, how to love yourself, how to stay attractive via text, games men play on women, or how to get your ex back, I have all these videos for sale on my website called gretaberishita.com, and I will drop a link in my video description below how to get them and as a pinned comment under this video. So if you like my video, please press like, share it with the ladies that need it. Join Greta's High Value Woman School, where we are all in the same boat learning how to be women of high value and bring out the best in our men. Follow me on my Instagram. My Instagram is called Ladies Relationship Coach. And for one-on-one group coaching or coaching with my team, book me through my website, which is called gretabrishita.com. Thank you for watching. Kisses from Dorset. Mwah.